streaming live on news8000.com. This is News 8 Now, This Morning.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Alexandra Carter.
I'm Jeff Anders.
It is Thursday, January 4th, 2024. Kind of living in like Groundhog Day this year, right? Every day the weather's kind of been the same.
As we get rolling out this morning, like yesterday and the day before, I was going to ask, well, you stepped outside for like a few seconds and
briefly.
You thought,
like,
well,
it didn't feel right. It didn't feel like too terrible. So I do have a garage,
no.
So I don't get that, you know, brisk of cold air hitting you, but
yeah, which is okay, really.
Yeah, when I was walking to the station,
you know, the cloud cover, we were slow to clear, so the temperatures kind of stayed up a little bit because I thought we, you know, with clear skies, we were going to drop into the teens.
Yeah.
That hasn't been the case. So you see, we have the cloud cover. I wouldn't say tremendously thick, but still, it's pretty cloudy right now across the area. Eventually, sunshine. Here's where we're sitting: 27 La Crosse and Viroqua. Now, Eau Claire 19, a little more clearing for Eau Claire. Black River Falls 24, 25, and Sparta generally in the mid 20s. As we go through the day today, I don't think we're going to drop back to the teens. We will have a little more sunshine today. We're going to spend most of the day upper 20s, struggling to hit 30 today. At least the winds are going to be on the light side. This is what we're looking at in La Crosse today: a mix of sun and clouds, struggling to hit 30 once again. Light winds, which is certainly a positive. That's the way I look at it. You don't get that biting kind of wind chill. All right, some things that are going to be talking about coming up in your full forecast. All right, the sun is back. Weekend snow potential. Also want to take a look at where these temperatures are headed, too. Got your full forecast. That's about 10 minutes away. Alexandra?
All right, Jeff, thank you. We'll see you in 10 minutes. Now for some stories we're following right now. Newly released court documents are providing new details about the sex trafficking case against Jeffrey Epstein. Among the records released last night are excerpts of depositions by Epstein's alleged victim, Virginia Jeffrey, and his longtime associate Ghislaine Maxwell. Maxwell was convicted in 2021 on child sex trafficking charges. She's currently serving a 20-year prison sentence. The depositions reference Britain's Prince Andrew, former President Bill Clinton, former New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson, and American investor Glenn Dubin. Clinton has previously acknowledged flying on one of Epstein's private planes, but denied knowing about his crimes. The documents do not contain a client list or directly implicate anyone listed of wrongdoing. To the border now, a political standoff underway between congressional Democrats and Republicans over the southern border. Both sides agree there are issues that need to be addressed, but don't agree on a solution to address them. Amy Kiley reports on the southern border negotiation stalemate currently being held in Congress.
America is at a breaking point with record levels of illegal immigration.
We have a broken immigration system. That is the one single fact about which everyone agrees.
What lawmakers don't agree on is how to fix it. A GOP visit to Eagle Pass, Texas yesterday is emphasizing that division and renewing calls for compromise.
H.R. 2 is the necessary ingredient.
H.R. 2 doesn't have Democratic votes.
H.R. 2 would codify some Trump-era border policies, like keeping migrants in Mexico during the asylum-seeking process. Even some lawmakers who support the plan say it's doomed.
I'm negotiating with a White House that vehemently disagrees and has already said they're going to veto that, and a Democratic Senate.
Instead of H.R. 2, the White House says it wants more funding for Border Patrol agents and immigration judges. Senate negotiators are working on bipartisan changes to asylum laws and parole policies. They're also considering more power for expulsions and border shutdowns. But many House Republicans say they'll only back H.R. 2 or a bill like it. That's even though senators are discussing ideas conservatives usually support.
Our goal has been to find a practical solution to the crisis.
The ongoing negotiations come as the Biden administration is currently suing the state of Texas over a controversial immigration law. That law allows local authorities to arrest migrants. Two people were back in Vernon County Court for drug trafficking and possession charges. Mark McKibben and Melinda Stahlsberg were arrested back in November after officers executed a search warrant and found 47 grams of meth, several bags of fentanyl, and cash, according to the county sheriff. McKibben is charged with felony counts of maintaining a drug trafficking place and possession with intent to deliver methamphetamine and fentanyl. Stahlsberg is charged with a felony count of possession with intent to deliver meth. Both are also charged with a misdemeanor count of possession of drug paraphernalia. They are both out on bond. Voters in La Crosse County can expect 20 contested elections for seats on the county board following Tuesday's filing deadline. Data from the county clerk's office shows 10 candidates will run unopposed, 8 of whom are incumbent on the board. All La Crosse County board members serve 2-year terms. In addition, county voters will vote in April for the circuit court judge. That seat was formerly held by Todd Bierke, who retired last year. The governor appointed Mark Huseman to finish out his term. Huseman will run against former judge Candace Tillistoch in the election April 2nd. Only two candidates, Tim Alberts and Adam Manka, met the filing deadline this week for 3 open seats on the La Crosse School Board. Last year, 9 candidates vied for 4 open seats. Alberts unsuccessfully ran last year. Manka is a senior at La Crosse Central High School who's campaigning on getting drugs out of schools. The 3 incumbents up for re-election, Annie Bowman, Brad Korberg, and Jeff Jackson, all decided not to seek another term. Additional candidates can still enter the race as write-ins. The La Crosse County Highway Department asking for public comments on the county's proposed 2024 ATV routes. Residents can send in questions or opinions about the expected routes to County Highway Commissioner Joe Langberg at the email you see on your screen. People can also respond by calling the Highway Department between 7 a.m. and 3 p.m. Monday through Friday, that is. The number is also on your screen. The county says all comments must be submitted by this Sunday, January 7th. Minnesota's state flag is getting a makeover. You see it right here. The makeover is stirring up a passionate debate across the state. Last spring, lawmakers launched a redesign effort to redesign the flag. In December, a selection committee unveiled the new design. But how do Minnesotans feel about the new flag facelift? News 8's Allison Furgit traveled to La Crescent to find out.
Out with the old and in with the new.
My initial thought is it seems kind of plain.
Minnesotans have a lot to say about their new state flag.
I'd at least put the loon back on it. I think that would be appropriate.
Last spring, the Minnesota State Legislature ordered a new state seal and flag to be designed, largely because critics said the images on the previous designs were problematic. The old state seal shows a white farmer plowing his field as a Native American rides off into the distance. The state seal was a prominent part of the old flag, which is why it also got a makeover.
I do agree that the old one with the center is just way too much on there.
I like the new one better.
What do you like about the new one?
I don't know. It's just that one's too busy.
More than 2,600 Minnesotans submitted a proposal, and after months of debate, the Emblems Redesign Commission settled on this design. The dark blue shape is to resemble Minnesota's outline. Inside of it, a white 8-pointed North Star representing the nickname the North Star State. And the light blue on the flag represents water, something the selection committee thought was perfect for the land of 10,000 lakes.
But I like it less abstract, a little more real.
But many Minnesotans are looking for more state representation.
Like, where's our state bird? I mean, there's things that could go in there that could have been added that it just seems very plain.
Loons are Minnesota's state bird, so let's do it.
The state seal also got a makeover. That new look has gotten a much warmer reception.
I like that a lot.
I like the state seal. I really do like that because it has a loon on there.
I'm proud of that. I'm not so proud of the flag.
The people want their loon. Unless rejected by the state legislature, the new emblems will become official May 11th. That is Minnesota's Statehood Day. But this isn't the only thing that's changing. Later in the hour, we'll take a quick look at some of the state's new license plate options. The time now is 5:09. Also still to come this morning, we'll take a look at some of the workforce and consumer trends you can expect in 2024 and tell you why they matter for your wallet.
A family lost tens of thousands of dollars in a case of cyber kidnapping. I'm Bradley Blackburn with how the scam works and how experts say you can protect yourself.
For now, we're sending you to break with something to put the good in your morning. Here's something fun to kick off your Thursday. An Oklahoma gamer just made history by doing something nobody has ever done before. He beat Tetris. Fans have been trying to beat the puzzle game since it came out in 1984. After 40 years of fast-falling cubes, awkward tees, and those pesky L pieces, many people just didn't think it was possible to beat the Nintendo Classic. Until now, 13-year-old Willis Gibson got so far in Tetris, his score hit 999,999. That's a lot of nines. At that point, it just shut off. Word of the win sent waves of excitement through the gaming community. You see his reaction here too. He's described the experience as, "I can't feel my fingers." Don't go anywhere. Your consumer news at News 8 Now this morning is after the break.
Hold on, I'm coming. You didn't tell me you were getting McDonald's.
Buy a sausage biscuit, sausage McMuffin, or sausage McGriddles and get one for $1.
This isn't Charmin. No wonder I don't feel as clean.
Here's Charmin Ultra Strong.
Ah, my bottom's been saved.
With its diamond weave texture, Charmin Ultra Strong cleans better with fewer sheets and less effort. Enjoy the go with Charmin.
It ain't my dad's razor, Dad.
Hey, watch it.
It's from Gillette Labs. This green bar releases trapped hairs from my face.
Game changer.
Well, the Flex This contours to it, so the 5 blades can get virtually every hair in one stroke for the ultimate Gillette shaving experience.
The best a man can get
is Gillette Labs.
Huga, a calm, comfortable time with people you love, often enjoyed with a good book, a warm blanket, and a crackling fire. Let La Crosse Fireplace Company help create this feeling in your home. Choose a heat and glow fireplace in gas, wood, or pellet. Stay warm and cozy with the heat and glow fireplace from La Crosse Fireplace Company, because your place is by the fire.
Pilgrims está creciendo y queremos que formes parte de una empresa exitosa, estable y segura. Estamos ofreciendo salarios más altos y más incentivos de pago que nunca. Visítenos en cualquier día para someter una solicitud de nuestra oficina de contratación o el miércoles para una entrevista inmediata. Ayúdenos a alimentar al mundo mientras le proporcionamos un entorno de trabajo seguro, un empleo estable y esencial con un salario fijo. Visítenos en cualquier momento en 502 West Main Street, Arcadia, Wisconsin, o someta su solicitud hoy en pilgrims.com.
Hey, Dominic here with great recipes using our Italian Pleasany. For Italian mushrooms, use a pint of mushrooms, 1 stick of butter, and 1 tablespoon of Italian Pleasany. Put in a slow cooker and cook on high for 4 hours. For Italian green beans, fry 4 chopped slices of bacon with 1/2 chopped onion. Cook 1 bag of green beans, combine everything, add in 1 teaspoon of Italian Pleasany. Get Italian Pleasany and over 40 other blends at the Pleasany Outlet Store on Ward Avenue, La Crosse.
Mwah!
Let's go!
On the Jennifer Hudson Show, I turn the spotlight on you. Inspiring stories.
I can do it!
That's right! The biggest stars.
You have your own show.
I love Jennifer.
Hey, guys!
Weekdays at 4 on News 8.
Glad you're with us this morning. It's almost 5:15, 5:13. A lot of cloud cover. The clearing has been very slow for us. That's at least held the temperatures up. La Crosse 27, but it's 19. It's dropped off in Eau Claire. I suspect the sky's a little clearer. 24, Black River Falls, Sparta about 25. Viroqua is at 27. Our highs expected today, the Coulee region, generally upper 20s to around 30. Berry Mills about 30. Middle Ridge 27. Shelby about 30 for the high. La Crosse as well. Holman about 28. Southern zones, maybe a couple degrees higher. Steuben 31, Gays Mills 31, Lanksville 31, Waukon about 28 for the high temperature today. A little further north, Winona 29 for the high today. Arcadia 28, Blair 27, Alma perhaps hitting 29 for the high today. In the Chippewa Valley, 23 for Ladysmith, 24 Cornell, Bloomer, Chippewa Falls, about 25 for the high temperatures today. You're going to be hanging outside, waiting for a lift. You're going to be outside for any period of time. This is what we're looking at. Fairly cloudy, mid-20s. At least the winds are going to be on the calm side. Maybe a little more sun as we get into the day. About 30. That's all we're going to hit today. That's still a little bit above the average, though. All right, where are the temperatures headed? And I know a lot of people thinking about the next chance at snow. I'll go through that, your full forecast. That is just coming up in less than 5 minutes. Alexander has your consumer news right now.
In this morning's Consumer Report, we'll take a look at the trends that may matter to your wallet in the new year. 2023 is over, but labor unions aren't going anywhere. Workers were so successful on the picket line last year, it was dubbed the Summer of the Strike. That included strikes by Hollywood writers and actors, auto workers, and healthcare professionals. Now, Vice President Kamala Harris is meeting with culinary workers in Nevada to congratulate them on contracts, new contracts with casinos. Those agreements include big raises and better job security. The trip comes as the White House ramps up campaign efforts in battleground states like Nevada. Another trend that looks like it'll continue in 2024, record high electric vehicle sales. IRS tax credits meant it was cheaper than ever to buy an EV in 2023, which experts say drove up sales. Now the agency says it's updating those tax rules for the new year. Fewer EVs will be eligible for the big $7,500 credit. But there is some good news. Consumers can now get tax credits applied to the purchase price of their new car instead of having to wait to file their taxes to cash in. Many people kicking off January with resolutions, of course, to eat healthy and work out more. But for others, ringing in the new year is about changing their work life. That could mean adding a part-time gig for some extra cash, starting a whole new job, or just making sure you're ready for whatever life throws at you in 2024. Whatever your goals are, updating your resume is a good place to start. Career expert Amanda Augustine has some tips to make sure your credentials are on point.
And how can I highlight a certain outcome or accomplishment that allowed me to leverage those skills? Let me mention them at the top of my resume and those core competencies. But then in the work history, I want to detail out and give examples of how I've leveraged those skills to provide value to my employers.
She also says it's a good idea to read your resume out loud to catch any typos or inconsistencies. According to Labor Department data out this week, there were 8.6 million job openings nationwide in November. That is down from the previous month, but still higher than historical levels. A family was duped out of tens of thousands of dollars when their son was the victim of cyber kidnapping. The strange case shows how scams are growing more complex. Bradley Blackburn has the details and what you can do to protect your family.
On New Year's Eve, authorities found a 17-year-old student camping alone in the Utah snow after he was forced into the wilderness by virtual kidnappers. The exchange student was told his family in China was in danger unless he isolated himself away from society and law enforcement. Police say the online scammers ordered him to take pictures they used to extort money from his relatives.
The family in China believes that the kidnappers are actually with their son. And so through these three-way phone calls and then with the photographs and whatnot. So it's kind of a double blind, if you will.
The boy's family sent some $80,000 to the criminals before they realized it was all a hoax. U.S. authorities worked with Chinese officials on the case. They believe other exchange students have been targeted in similar scams.
They're on the other side of the world, so it helps the cyber criminals.
Security expert Scott Schober says these crimes are growing more sophisticated.
These scams are continually evolving. What doesn't work, then they're going to try to switch up the tactics and try something else.
To protect yourself, experts say think carefully before you post personal details online, like birthdays. Make sure you're using two-factor authentication and complex passwords for your accounts.
And if there's a threat, someone's demanding money, it's an urgent situation, take a step back and call police.
Call police. First thing to do, call police. Again, they're trained, they're professional, they do this every single day.
And be aware that these days, anyone can be a target.
So scary. Some scammers have even used AI to fake voices or images of supposed kidnapping victims. And experts say criminals often gather information from online posts and use it for social engineering. That does it for your morning consumer news. The time now is 5:19. Let's check in with News 8 meteorologist Jeff Andrews for a look at today's forecast.
Generally a quiet start for our day today. City Cam 8, nothing, no shockers as you had to and out the door today. Chilly, the winds are light, no precipitation to speak of. All right, generally this is a cloudy stretch we're in. We'll see a little more sunshine today. Still above normal as far as our temperatures, but we are trending closer to normal as we roll into next week. We have snow opportunities this weekend, next week as well. Right now, I see all this cloud cover. As far as any kind of precipitation, really nothing for us to speak of. The East Coast, they're seeing a lot of rain, certainly along the ocean. All right, for us, a lot of cloud cover across the area. This is what we're headed to today. Now, 27 right now. It feels like 19. Winds north at about 7 miles an hour. High pressure builds in for us. Eau Claire's at 19. Even with the cloud cover, it feels like 12. The winds are pretty light right now, generally across the area. And generally, they're going to be shifting a little bit. It's kind of all over the place, really. It's because the winds are pretty negligible at this point. Across the country, all right, high pressure builds in for us. This is what I'm watching for our snow potential as we get into the weekend. Watch as this system evolves. Into the weekend, all right, this is really Saturday, Sunday. Saturday morning is what I'm looking at right now. You can see it tends to look like it's going to skirt around us as far as the snow. We'll probably see a little bit over the weekend. The key in that whole thing is little. All right, up close today, you see the cloud cover. We'll have a little more sunshine today, but still clouds pretty prevalent in our day-to-day. Even with the high pressure building in, Friday more cloud cover back into the picture for us. We start to see the potential of maybe a little bit of snow as we get into the weekend. Still kind of watching that evolve a little bit, but I don't think we're going to see much out of it. Today, I'd like to see a little more sunshine, brighten things up a little bit. We're going to have the cloud cover with us. By noon, probably the middle 20s. We'll struggle to hit 30 for our high today. Some other spots like Sparta 28, Black River Falls, expecting 27, same for Eau Claire. Winona potentially 29 for the high temperature, a little further north. Ladysmith only 23 for the high temperature. Probably a chilly night for us as we head into our Friday, even with the cloud cover, pretty close to about 20. For a Friday, fairly cloudy, about 36 for the high temperature. On Saturday, mostly cloudy, up to 36. On Sunday, mostly cloudy, we'll call it partly sunny, about 33 for the high. Possibility of seeing a little bit of light snow. Still watching that track closely, but I'm pretty confident it's going to be light amounts. Now, into next week, the potential for a storm. Now, as far as us getting anything out of the storm, not looking that way, but certainly watching that as well. Alexandra?
Thank you, Jeff. Time now is 5:22, still to come on your morning news. If one of your 2024 New Year's resolutions is to eat healthier this year, you may want to stick around. Coming up, we'll take a look at what diet has been ranked the best overall diet for the seventh straight year.
The UWL women's basketball team has won four straight. Eagles tipping off WIAC play last night at Mitchell Hall. Plus, the Bucks were looking to bounce back against the Pacers. All that coming up in the Blitz.
Hardee's double deals start at $2.99. Choose a double cheeseburger, bacon double cheeseburger, or new barbecue bacon double cheeseburger. $2.99 never looked so good. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
We all need fiber for our digestive health, but less than 10% of us get enough each day. Good thing Metamucil gummies are an easy way to get prebiotic plant-based fiber with the same amount of fiber as 2 cups of broccoli. Metamucil gummies, the easy way to get your daily fiber.
Sometimes Jonah wrestles with falling asleep, so he takes ZQL, the world's number one sleep aid brand, and wakes up feeling like himself. Get the rest to be your best with non-habit-forming ZQL. Better days start with ZQL Nights.
Time is running out on Southern Minnesota's biggest and best furniture sale, the huge New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain. It's everything you've asked for, like 36-month special financing, store-wide sale prices, and free gas just for shopping. At Drury's, you'll save on the area's finest selection of quality brands like Smith Brothers, FlexSteel, and Daniel's Amish, all at incredible savings. The New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain. But you'll have to hurry. It all ends Monday at 8.
At U.S. Cellular, anyone can get any phone free.
Mm-hmm.
So give yourself a free phone from U.S. Cellular.
She's here.
Then give yourself the gift of not checking it. The gift of connection at U.S. Cellular. New and current customers get any phone free.
No matter your level of comfort with technology, our secure website allows for worry-free transactions. Whether at your computer or in the palm of your hand, our mobile app lets you manage your account on the go. For over 120 years, Union State Bank has provided our customers and community with quality financial services. We're here for you and welcome you to bank with us.
Union State Bank, where customers and community come first. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Honey, where are the kids?
I put them in the furnace so I could figure out why we don't have any heat.
You did what?
Maybe it's that loose wire.
Maybe it's that plug vent.
Maybe it's the bad igniter.
Maybe it's a dirty flame sensor.
Or maybe...
Why don't we just call J&T Heat and Air Conditioning?
Quality you can count on, experience you can trust.
With over 50 years of combined experience, J&T services residential and commercial customers within 50 miles of West Salem.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose your favorite flavors for endless combinations. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
The Board Store Home Improvements family wishes you a happy new year. Visit soon to plan your 2024 home improvement project. It's never too early to dream.
Welcome to the Blitz. The UW lacrosse women's basketball team began the season 3-4, but since that point, the Eagles have reeled off four straight wins, and they're red hot as conference play tipped off last night. Let's go to Mitchell Hall. Eagles opening WIAC play against UW River Falls. Pick it up first quarter. Lauren Milne knocks down the J. Lacrosse up four. Then more from the home team. Kylie Meeker racing to the cup. Strong finish off the glass. Count it. Plus the foul. Eagles go up by seven. But the Falcons clawing back. Nice drive here. This goes off the window for two plus one. It's back to a five-point game. Other end, Eagles get hot. Katie Walkow, step back three. Money. Lacrosse still in front. River Falls still fighting back, though. Zoe Buchan, again, this time from downtown. She drains the three. It's a two-point game. Eagles answer, though. First half winding down. It's Meeker in the lane. She gets this one to fall. Lacrosse trailed going into the locker room, but in the second half, Eagles turning it up a notch. Milne stopping on a dime for two. Then later in the third, Madison Kilboten spots up in the corner. She knocks down the three. Back and forth game at Mitchell Hall, but the Eagles open up conference play with the win, 66-62. As for the men's squad, the Eagles were on the road last night, tipping off WIAC play against the Falcons. Lacrosse comes up short in River Falls, 71-62. Eagles led it by three at the break. UWL outscored 38-26 in the second half. Eagles dropped their conference opener. They'll have a chance to get back on track Saturday at home against UW Stevens Point. Bucks back on the road last night looking for a win over those pesky Pacers. Tight one in the second. Bucks up one until this turnover. Aaron Naismith takes it all the way. Indiana jumps back in front. Bucks answer back, though. Dame Lillard goes around the screen, gets hit from behind. Doesn't matter. Milwaukee goes up three. Then off the inbounds pass, Chris Middleton bullies his way up for two, and the foul. It's a five-point lead. But second half, all Pacers. Miles Turner is going to throw it down. Indiana goes up by a dozen. Then more sloppy play from the Bucks. Buddy Hield gets the steal off the backboard to Isaiah Jackson for the slam. And the Oshkosh native Tyrese Halliburton, another dominant performance. Game-high 31 points on the night for him. Bucks drop their second straight, 142-130. T-Wolves back at home last night hosting the Pelicans. Second quarter, Minnesota down five until Naz Reid connects from downtown. That cuts it back to two. But on the other end, Brandon Ingram says, I can do that as well. He knocks down the three. Then in the third, Pelicans rolling. C.J. McCollum splashes home the triple. New Orleans goes up by a dozen. And the Pels start pulling away. Look at this defense here. Big-time block from Zion Williamson. And that leads to this. Other end, it's Ingram again. Fall away. Jay is pure. Tough night for the T-Wolves. They drop their second straight, 117-106. That's going to do it for the Blitz. We'll see you tonight.
Hardee's double deals start at $2.99. Choose a double cheeseburger, bacon double cheeseburger, or new barbecue bacon double cheeseburger. $2.99 never looked so good. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you equipped with quality tools and project supplies because we get you. Whether you're a hardworking pro or an ambitious DIYer, we get you what you need to get the job done. Right now, save on 80-piece Milwaukee bit sets, $24.99. This Craftsman propane heater, only $89.99. Plus, trade in any used power or hand tool for exclusive trade-in savings on select DeWalt tools and accessories. We get you what you need because we get you. At Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Want luxury hair repair that doesn't cost $50? Pantene's Pro Vitamin Formula repairs hair, as well as the leading luxury bonding treatment for softness and resilience without the price tag. If you know, you know it's Pantene.
Listen, your deodorant just has to work. I use Secret, aluminum-free. Just swipe and it lasts all day. Secret helps eliminate odor instead of just masking it. And hours later, I still smell fresh. Secret works. Oh, yes.
The one certainty in dentistry is nothing fixes itself. So small problems can turn into big problems if people wait. So they shouldn't wait.
Almost every time people say, man, that really wasn't that bad. I wish I had done that sooner.
We're a very implant-focused practice, so we deal with a lot of people who are losing teeth. If you've been avoiding solving it or waiting a long time, there's really no reason not to just solve it now.
If you think you have a full mouth of challenges, why don't you come down and meet us and see what we can do to help you?
There's always a solution.
Escape the chaos of everyday life and experience true relaxation and improved health at Revive Wellness Spa. Unlike any spa in the area, Revive Wellness Spa is your first choice for self-care. Our services include red light therapy, meditation pod, an infrared sauna, a float tank, and so much more. Call or book online today and receive up to 60% off your first service. Don't forget to ask about our detox specials.
Ho-Chunk Gaming Black River Falls presents Matt Stell. Don't miss this multi-platinum country artist live February 16th. I moved everywhere but on. Matt Stell with opening act Mason-Dixon Line. $35 tickets include $15 free rewards play. Available now on Ticketmaster.com. Don't miss Matt Stell February 16th at Ho-Chunk Gaming Black River Falls. Must be 21 or over to attend.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose your favorite flavors for endless combinations. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Thank you for watching News 8 Now. Expect more.
Welcome back. In your morning medical news, how'd you sleep last night? A new study reveals getting a bad night's sleep may not only make you tired the next day, it could also affect you 10 years from now. In the study, researchers looked at the sleep quality of people in their 30s and 40s, then gave 500 of them cognitive tests 10 years later. They found that those with more interruptions in their sleep were more than twice as likely to develop memory and thinking problems a decade later. If eating healthier is one of your New Year's resolutions, you may want to look into a Mediterranean diet. U.S. News & World Report is ranking it as the best overall diet for the seventh straight year. That diet consists primarily of fruits, vegetables, whole grains, beans, seeds, and fish, which all contain omega-3 fatty acids. According to the National Institutes of Health, omega-3 fatty acids can lower the risk of developing cardiovascular disease and age-related macular degeneration. The diet also took first as the best diet for diabetes, best for bone and joints, and best diet for healthy eating. Speaking of hitting those goals, 2024 is here, and so are many people's resolutions to live healthier. It's one of the most popular New Year's commitments as people aspire to be refreshed physically, mentally, and spiritually. But as the calendar changes, so do those everyday workout excuses. To keep your fitness goals on track, News 8 Now's Michael Germain met with a Gunderson wellness consultant who has some advice on making wellness wins stick in the new year.
It's always good to think of goals that are specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and you have a time factor. Figure out when you're going to do your goals.
If you're thinking about being more active for 2024,
Bolin adds you should aim for a 30-minute workout at least 5 times a week.
So if you think about exercising for 30 minutes a day, if you haven't exercised in a while, maybe break those 30 minutes into 3 10-minute segments.
While trying to achieve your New Year's resolution, it is important to have a positive mindset.
It's not going to be easy. You might have hiccups along the way. Things might not go as you planned, but brush that off, move on, and figure out maybe what caused you to not accomplish your goal on any given day.
Even though many folks set resolutions for the new year, Bolin adds it's best to think long term.
It's also important to keep setting goals, whether they're big or small, throughout the entire year, just to stay motivated, make your health and your happiness a priority all year long.
While hitting the gym and living a healthier lifestyle may be the most popular resolution, there are many other ways to improve your health.
Maybe it's learning a new hobby. Maybe it's taking a woodworking class. Maybe it's crafting. Whatever you want to do to better your physical and mental health, those are good goals to set.
A longtime YMCA member, Tim Ebner, says this time of year, he sees a rise in people flooding the floors.
Well, you always see an increase at this time of the year. It's just where people start to really think about what they want this upcoming year to be, and this is a good place to start here at the Y.
And Gunderson officials add setting goals with a specific plan to achieve them is the key there. The Children's Museum of La Crosse is welcoming some special guests. The organization known as Drawn Together is a group of artists that travel around La Crosse and paint. The group likes to find inspiration from unique places. This week, they decided to spend time in the Children's Museum, drawing in their sketchbooks. One artist says the best thing about the group is being able to connect with other artists.
Being in contact with the people, people who are going through the same kinds of challenges that all artists do, encouraging each other, giving each other feedback.
Gunn says right now there are about 18 members in Drawn Together. It's made up of working artists, people looking to start their art careers, and people who make art as a hobby. Earlier in the show, we took a look at what Minnesotans thought about the changes to their state flag. But not only is the state flag getting a change, Minnesotans can now show off their favorite sports teams with new license plates. Uba Ali gives us a closer look at some of the state's new specialty plate designs.
From the field to the dugout, Minnesota sports fans can now showcase their pride beyond the stands and on the road. With 9 special license plates, including pro sports teams, 2 nonprofits, and a blackout look.
Very excited to see those plates on the road starting today.
It gives our fans a chance to be able to show their pride.
The new plates will cost about $15 and require a minimum annual contribution of $30. Proceeds will go towards charitable organizations like the Minnesota Vikings Foundation and its mission to advance youth health and education, or the Minnesota Community Twins Fund supporting healthy children on and off the field.
So it's a great way for fans to show off their excitement and passion for the Minnesota Vikings, while helping support a wonderful cause.
Brett Tabor with the Minnesota Vikings Foundation says this is a tangible way to make a difference.
That $30 that a fan were able to contribute, that means real tangible meals for kids in our communities.
For Twins Territory, an opportunity to reach more children.
Community Fund funds programs and opportunities for youth to be able to connect with our game.
Drivers can also get plates to benefit the Lions Club, and the boldest plate is the blackout plate featuring white lettering. It's been so popular in other states, drivers asked for it to be added. Proceeds will help programs at DVS.
If you'd like to get one of those new specialty plates, you can visit your local deputy registrar's office or visit the Minnesota Public Safety Department's website. Now here's News 8 meteorologist Jeff Andrews to tell us what to expect for your morning commute with your new license plate, maybe.
Perhaps. I don't know if that'll affect your commute at all. Really, nothing looks to affect our commute. Weather-wise, get to green light across the board today. We'll likely see a little more sun. That isn't saying a whole lot because we haven't had much the last few days. But there's still going to be the cloud cover along the way today. So a little bit improvement as far as that goes. Look how cloudy it is right now across the area. The flurries and such. That's really to our north at this point. We just have the cloud cover. Temperatures have held up a little bit. We're mainly in the middle 20s at this point. 27 Winona and La Crosse. Eau Claire has dropped to 19. Same for Ladysmith, Black River Falls, and Sparta, about 24 right now. Mix of sun and clouds today, perhaps 34 La Crosse. The winds will be light, so we're not going to be dealing with that biting wind chill. Tonight down to 20. Quiet night for us, but a cold night for Eau Claire, about 27 with a mix of sun and clouds today, and the winds light as well. Down to 18 tonight for Eau Claire. So a decent day, at least as far as the weather and the roadways in combination. I'm going to go through the rest of the week, show you our next snow chances. I've got your full forecast next. We're going to follow that up with your morning buzz report. We're going to be taking a look in depth at some of the historical movies that hit the theaters and streaming platforms recently. Why? It's sometimes where we find the best stories, the true stories. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
To 50 years with my best friend and my soulmate.
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Only Bounty absorbs spills like a sponge, and Bounty is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less and get the job done with one.
You've got a bit of your face on your face.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper. And get 4 rolls in 1 with the Bounty Mega Roll, our longest lasting roll.
Our hearing connects us with people. And when that bridge is broken, our job is to help people with that hearing loss and reconnect them back with their lives again. We really feel that better hearing is a better life.
Happy holidays from everyone at Better Hearing Center.
We all know how weather goes around here, so why not take the First Warn team with you? Stay weather aware with hourly temps and conditions, video forecasts, and interactive radar. And the best part? It's easy to use. Here, try it.
When you feel that chill in the air, make sure your furnace will keep you comfortable.
Call G&T Heating and Air Conditioning. Quality you can count on, experience you can trust.
With over 50 years of combined experience, G&T services residential and commercial within 50 miles of West Salem.
Are you or a loved one having troubles getting in and out of the bathtub safely? Has the high cost of remodeling left you without options? I'm Tim with Tri-State Tub to Shower Conversions, and I've been serving the Tri-State area since 1992. And I would love to make your bathing experience safe and affordable. We use your existing tub and remove the front section for easy accessibility. And for an affordable cost, call today.
It's time for more fun moments at Fanati's.
Hi, everybody. Good to see you.
Hi.
Come on in. Take a look around.
Fanati's has so many treats, it'll make you feel like a kid in a candy store.
Look at all the candy kids.
Or a mom.
And all the kids.
Or a grandma.
You guys got some awesome treats today. Hope you had a lot of fun.
Brought to you locally by Fanati's Nut and Chocolate Shop in downtown La Crosse.
Good morning, glad you're with us for News 8 Now this morning. It's just about 5:45, 5:43. City Cam 8, it's quiet. Go to and out the door. What to expect? Not a whole lot. Nothing that's really going to jolt you. We should see a little more sun today. These are important things I want to share with you, and I'll go through it in detail. Temperatures still above normal, but we're going to be trending more towards normal. And we have snow chances, including this weekend. Right now, it's just a lot of cloud cover across the country. Some flurries to the north and east of us. You see, we've got the cloud cover across our area. Maybe some stray flurries. Really not in our viewing area. La Crosse is cloudy. Feels like 19. It's showing a north breeze at 7. The winds are going to be on the lighter side today. Probably won't even notice it all that much. Direction-wise, likely out of the southwest. Eau Claire, 19. It's pretty calm right now. It's chillier. All right, the big picture here is what I'm watching. Now, we have high pressure building in for us. That's today. This is what I'm watching for the next potential snowfall for us. It's in the southwest right now. It evolves as we go through Friday. You can see it's really to our south. This is Friday. Then we get into the weekend, and really it tracks south of us and east. The East Coast is likely to see a little more activity for us. Perhaps some light snow over the weekend. More cloud cover. That continues with us as well. All right, today up close, you see we've got some cloud cover here and there. Skies will clear a little bit. But we'll have the cloud cover with us as well. Just an improvement a little bit as far as some sunshine, though. It helps. On Friday, we cloud back up again, mostly cloudy. Then we start to see the snow potential. Most of it's around us, what there is over the weekend. As far as it adding up, you look to the north. Maybe I-94 and north could see an inch or two or so. Most of us, probably about a half inch or so over the weekend. The timing's still evolving a little bit. As we go through our day today, a mix of sun and clouds. So you head towards the noon hour, mid-upper 20s across the area with at least light winds for us. La Crosse 30, Eau Claire 27, Ladysmith, a mere 23 for the high today. Prairie du Chien 31, Boscobel about 33 for the high. Over the longer stretch, we're still trending a bit above normal. We're seeing more of these colors. Gray would be about normal. So we're starting to come back to, I guess we'd say, a little more along the lines of reality, or at least normal. You look towards the West Coast, they're still seeing below normal, way below normal temperatures. About 30 potentially for our high today. Heading down to 20 as we start our Friday. A lot of cloud cover on our Friday. Again, high 34. Saturday, partly sunny 36. Sunday, partly sunny 33. With some light snow opportunities over the weekend. Here's your Buzz Report with Alexandra.
Today we're bringing you a spotlight on movies that deal with history, because sometimes the best story is a true story. Some of the most acclaimed movies of 2023 tackled history. That includes Martin Scorsese's Killers of the Flower Moon, which just grabbed 4 wins at the Alliance of Women Film Journalist Awards. The epic Western drama took home the trophies for Best Actress and Best Breakthrough Performance for star Lily Gladstone. It also won Best Cinematography and Best Editing.
Thank you. You almost made me cry.
Speaking of talented women, Paramount is releasing the trailer for its upcoming documentary about June Carter Cash. The doc will tell the story of the country icon and with rare, never-before-seen footage. Although married to fellow Nashville star Johnny Cash, June was a music legend and pioneer in her own right. Fans can learn all about the life of the 5-time Grammy winner when June premieres on January 16th.
Sabemos dónde estamos. Pasa cuando el mundo te abandona.
That was a quick sneak peek at historical drama Society of the Snow. It's a true story about a rugby team whose plane crashed in the Andes Mountains in 1972. The survival thriller explores how 16 members of the team overcame incredible odds to survive the ordeal. Society of the Snow landed in theaters late last month and is already getting major Oscar buzz from critics. It currently holds a 92% rating on Rotten Tomatoes.
Sadly, now federal agents have learned what the locals long suspected, that the group calling itself God's Marines would not give up without a fight.
Here's another harrowing true story that just hit streaming services. The FBI True episode Waco is a two-part look at the 1993 standoff between federal law enforcement and the Branch Davidians. You may remember that group as the Colt, who waged a bloody gun battle with the FBI before holding up for what became a 51-day siege at their Texas compound. Four federal agents died in the firefight, while 82 Branch Davidians perished when the siege ended in a fire. The events in Waco remain controversial today. You can watch FBI True on Paramount Plus now. Yeah, that Waco story, they seem to do documentary after documentary. It is really interesting.
It definitely is interesting. I think they're cheaper to make, too, generally speaking. I think that plays into it. How about that one about the plane crashing and the snow?
Yeah, that seems harrowing indeed.
Yeah, harrowing, good way to describe it, yes.
Yes, yes. Woo. Scary stuff there. Well, from scary to some celebrating now.
Yes.
Before we head to break, it's time to look at today's Look Who's 8.
All right, Camden turns 8 years old today. He likes to practice karate, play video games, and believe it or not, he likes to do math.
Good for him. We have Ruth turning 88 years old today. She's a huge fan of all of the major Wisconsin sports teams, loves playing bingo, and watching game shows.
You know somebody special has got a birthday coming up. They're turning 8, 18, 88, 88 weeks, what have you. We'd love to feature them.
Yeah, just upload their photo to our website, news8000.com, and look for the Submit Pictures button underneath the Home tab. Stay with us. We have everything you need to know today in 5 minutes or less. Your morning news now is up next.
At Union State Bank, we provide quality products and services to help make your banking easier. When it comes to your money, you want a bank you can rely on.
As you grow, so will your financial goals. It's important to have a partner who listens and responds with honest recommendations you can trust.
Our team is not only committed to serving the families and businesses in our community, we are also from the community.
We're here for you, and we welcome you to bank with us. Union State Bank, where customers and community come first. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
I'm coming.
You didn't tell me you were getting McDonald's.
Buy a sausage biscuit, sausage McMuffin, or sausage McGriddles, and get one for $1.
I love that my daughter still needs me, but sometimes I can't help due to burning and stabbing pain in my hands. So I use Nervive.
Nervive's clinical dose of ALA reduces nerve discomfort in as little as 14 days.
Now I can help again. Feel the difference with Nervive.
Jordan's sore nose let out a fiery sneeze, so Dad grabbed Puffs Plus Lotion to soothe her with ease. Puffs Plus Lotion is gentle on sensitive skin and locks in moisture to provide soothing relief. A nose in need deserves Puffs indeed. America's number one lotion tissue.
Welcome to Wesco. Welcome to huge selection and savings. Who wants free furniture? This month only, one lucky Wesco shopper will have their entire furniture order refunded. That's right, get your entire furniture order refunded. Will it be you? Plus, everyone gets up to 20% off in select departments store-wide. Did I mention free furniture? This month only, one lucky Wesco shopper will have their entire furniture order refunded. Wesco and Sparta, where white glove delivery and setup are always free. Tell them Peyton sent you.
Welcome back. It's 5:51. Time for your morning news now. Two people were back in Vernon County Court for drug trafficking and possession charges. 37-year-old Mark McKibben and 36-year-old Melinda Stahlsberg were arrested in November after officers executed a search warrant and found 47 grams of meth, several bags of fentanyl, and cash, according to the county sheriff. McKibben charged with felony counts of maintaining a drug trafficking place and possession with intent to deliver methamphetamine and fentanyl. Stahlsberg charged with a felony count of possession with intent to deliver meth. Both are also charged with a misdemeanor count of possession of drug paraphernalia. They are out of jail on bond. Voters in La Crosse County can expect 20 contested elections, 4 seats on the county board. Following Tuesday's filing deadline, data from the county clerk's office shows 10 candidates will run unopposed, 8 of whom are incumbents on the board. All La Crosse County board members serve 2-year terms. In addition, county voters will vote in April for the circuit court judge seat formerly held by Todd Bierke, who retired last year. The governor appointed Mark Huseman to finish out his term. Huseman will run against former Judge Candace Tillistoch in the election April 2nd. The La Crosse County Highway Department asking for your input on the county's proposed 2024 ATV routes. Residents can send in questions or opinions about the expected routes to County Highway Commissioner Joe Langberg at the email on your screen. You can also respond by calling the Highway Department. They're open from 7 to 3 Monday through Friday. That number is also on your screen. The county says all comments must be submitted by this Sunday. That's January 7th. A new year means many are embracing those New Year's resolutions for a healthier lifestyle. A wellness consultant at Gunderson has some tips for us on how to turn your January goals into an all-year reality. If you're thinking about becoming more active in the new year, they suggest aiming for a 30-minute workout at least 5 times a week. And remember to think long-term. Multiple small goals throughout the year can go a long way.
It's great to set goals in January, but it's also important to keep setting goals, whether they're big or small, throughout the entire year, just to stay motivated, make your health and your happiness a priority all year long.
Boland also says to have a plan in place when setting a goal. This will help make the goals easier to reach.
All right, here's what we can expect today. Mix of sun and clouds, a little cooler. We'll spend most of the day in the 20s, but the winds will be light, so we won't have, you know, a nasty wind chill to go with it as well. About 30 for the high temperature. That's kind of my expectation for La Crosse. So Clara, 27, mix of sun and clouds. Yes, on the cooler side, but once again, the winds on the lighter side. With weekend snow potential, better chance of seeing something measurable next week.
All right, well, hold off on sipping your coffee for a moment. We're about to take a little walk on the wild side to finish up our show this hour. A group of senior women in Massachusetts are getting saucy for a good cause and showing that sometimes age is just a number. The ladies range from their late 60s to early 90s, and they came up with a creative and spicy way. Yeah. To raise money for their senior living community. The group held a boudoir photo shoot and puts together a flirty calendar in the name of charity. They've already sold over 700 calendars to raise 14 grand, something you don't see every day.
No.
I think they made a movie about that. Calendar boudoir. Girls? Yeah. Calendar Girls, have you seen it?
I have not.
Me neither, but I've heard about it. Well, good for them. And thank you so much for joining us this morning. We will see you back here at 6. Coming up at the top of the hour, Minnesota's new state flag is drawing some strong emotions across the North Star State. We headed out to gauge opinions on whether the fresh look is a design win or an epic fail.
The Biden administration is locked in a border battle. I'm Jared Hill with the latest lawsuit against Texas as Republicans push the White House to do more.
Wow.
Did you touch the thermostat? Did you turn it up?
Of course not. Did somebody fiddle with the thermostat?
Dude, it's 85 degrees.
85? Do you have any idea what a couple degrees will do to our gas bill?
Why is it so hot here?
Someone turned up the heat.
God. What do you think you're doing?
I like to sleep with my window open.
You are not supposed to touch a thermostat.
Get away in your home with new upholstery from Black River Furniture Outlet.
Shop our huge inventory of Ashley sectionals, sofas, and love seats. Great discounts on recliners and reclining furniture with power features like adjustable headrest, heat, or massage.
Customize your feel with best home furnishings.
Go smaller or go the beast.
Upgrade to power or change fabrics. And if you need a lift, shop our full line of lift chairs. Plus, try out our latest hybrid, gel, and all-foam mattresses on a new adjustable base.
Family and veteran-owned, Black River Furniture Outlet, Black River Falls.
News 8 Now and the Co-op Credit Union are taking part in Chase the Chill.
Chase the Chill is a project across North America that provides warm clothing to people in need. Scarves, hats, and gloves are hung on trees in parks with notes attached to them, letting people know they can take them.
Co-op Credit Union and our community are conducting our own Chase the Chill campaign from December through February.
Together, we can keep our community warm this winter.
Donations will be accepted at the Co-op Credit Union location in Onalaska.
If you want the best dental care ever, come to Grand River Dental. They will take care of you. They put you in control of your own treatment. It was like over and done with in a short amount of time. You'll walk out of here feeling great and probably want more work done because they do such an awesome job. I mean, look at how pretty these look. It'll change your life.
We're an implant-focused practice. If you think you have a full mouth of challenges, come see me. Come down for a free consultation.
Want luxury hair repair that doesn't cost $50? Pantene's Pro Vitamin Formula repairs hair, as well as the leading luxury bonding treatment for softness and resilience without the price tag. If you know, you know it's Pantene. Mama.
For fast sore throat relief, try Vicks VapoCool Drops. With 2 times more menthol per drop and powerful Vicks vapors to vaporize sore throat pain. Vicks VapoCool Drops, vaporize sore throat pain.
The Board Store Home Improvements family wishes you a happy new year. Visit soon to plan your 2024 home improvement project. It's never too early to dream.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Alexandra Carter.
I'm Jeff Andrews.
It is Thursday, January 4th, 2024. Not much to expect weather-wise today, but you are tracking a potential snowmaker coming our way eventually.
Yes, things have been quiet, uneventful. Yeah. I mean, not that we want winter drama for the most part, but I know some folks would probably like to snowmobile, maybe ice fish, I don't know, what
Skiing,
have you. Skiing,
yeah.
I forgot about that. Yes, there are a couple opportunities where we could see some snow over the next week or so.
Okay.
All right, probably this weekend. Today it's just a lot of cloud cover for us. The several things didn't really come into play, allowing us to clear off last night. The low to our north and east is tracking very slow, high pressure, slow to build in. 27 La Crosse, 19 in Eau Claire right now. That's kind of where the ranges are. Prairie du Chien, Boscobel further south, about 29. With a mix of sun and clouds, probably about 30 for our high today. The winds will be on the lighter side. A little cooler, about 27 in the potential high for Eau Claire today. Once again, with a light wind. Some things that I want to share with you are weather headlines. More sunshine today, still a little bit above normal. And we have to look at the snow chances. I'll do that, your full forecast. That's less than 10 minutes away. Alexandra?
All right, Jeff, we will see you then. Thank you. Time now for the stories we're following right now. Japanese authorities releasing new details on Tuesday's deadly plane crash that killed 5 Japan Coast Guard members. Japanese officials say after reviewing control tower transcripts, the Japan Airlines A350 passenger jet was given clearance to land at Tokyo's Haneda Airport. However, the smaller Coast Guard aircraft that it collided with was not given permission to take off. All 379 people on board of that Japan Airlines flight were able to evacuate the aircraft safely. Travelers at Haneda Airport are still dealing with flight cancellation and delays this morning. To newly released court documents now, providing new details about the sex trafficking case against Jeffrey Epstein. Among the records released last night are excerpts of depositions by Epstein's alleged victim, Virginia Giuffre, and his longtime associate, Ghislaine Maxwell. Maxwell was convicted in 2021 on child sex trafficking charges and is currently serving a 20-year prison sentence. The depositions reference Britain's Prince Andrew, former President Bill Clinton, former New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson, and American investor Glenn Dubin. Clinton has previously acknowledged flying on one of Epstein's private planes, but denied knowing about his crimes. The documents do not contain a client list or directly implicate anyone listed of wrongdoing. To the border now, the Biden administration is in 2 political standoffs over the southern border, one with the state of Texas, another with congressional Republicans over the border crisis. Yesterday, a group of more than 60 Republican lawmakers traveled to the border for a firsthand look at the situation. It comes as the number of migrants crossing has dropped this week compared to the record highs we saw just weeks ago. CBS News correspondent Jared Hill has more for us from New York.
In a battle over border policy, the Biden administration is now suing to block a Texas law that allows state and local law enforcement to arrest and deport people suspected of crossing the border illegally. It comes as the White House and Congress remain at a standstill over legislation that would include border security. Yesterday, Republican House Speaker Mike Johnson led a group of GOP lawmakers to Eagle Pass, Texas, to get an up-close look at the crisis.
America is at a breaking point.
While there, a group of migrants from Venezuela were seen trying to cross into the U.S. In a sit-down with CBS News' Margaret Brennan, Johnson later urged President Biden to exercise executive action.
The catch and release program has created part of this problem. You could end catch and release.
It's very nice that they have a trip to the border, but the only way to solve this is here, working in a bipartisan way.
On Capitol Hill, negotiations continue toward a package that would include immigration measures and security funding for Israel and Ukraine. President Biden sent his top cabinet officials to Mexico just last week to discuss the issue. This week, he also placed blame on Republicans in Congress.
They ought to give me the money I need to protect the border.
New Border Patrol numbers show a dramatic drop from last month's highs of as many as 10,000 migrant apprehensions per day to about 4,000 on Tuesday.
And U.S. officials attributing that drop in migrant apprehensions to the holiday and increased immigration enforcement by Mexico. Back here at home, two people back in Vernon County Court for drug trafficking and possession charges. Mark McKibben and Melinda Stahlsberg were arrested in November after officers executed a search warrant and found 47 grams of meth, several bags of fentanyl, and cash, according to the county sheriff. McKibben is charged with felony counts of maintaining a drug trafficking place and possession with intent to deliver methamphetamine and fentanyl. Stahlsberg is charged with a felony count of possession with intent to deliver meth, both also facing a misdemeanor count of possession of drug paraphernalia. They are both out on bond. A new bill in Wisconsin would require officials at the University of Wisconsin to inform out-of-state students how they can vote absentee in their home districts. State Representative Clint Moses is sponsoring the bill. The Menominee Republican says it would allow those out-of-state students to vote in their home districts where they know more about local issues. He says he's concerned about students deciding local races here, like school board or a referendum. Democrats oppose the bill, claiming it aims to suppress college-aged voters who lean Democratic in an increasingly purple state. Wisconsin already led the nation in youth voter turnout during the 22 midterms. Only two candidates, Tim Alberts and Adam Manka, met the filing deadline this week for three open seats on the La Crosse School Board. Last year, nine candidates vied for four open seats. Alberts unsuccessfully ran last year. Manka is a senior at La Crosse Central High School who is campaigning on getting drugs out of schools. The three incumbents up for re-election, Annie Bowman, Brad Korberg, and Jeff Jackson, all decided not to seek another term. Additional candidates can still enter the race as a write-in. The La Crosse County Highway Department is asking for your comment on the county's proposed 2024 ATV routes. Residents can send in their questions or opinions about the expected routes to County Highway Commissioner Joe Langberg at the email you see on your screen, or you can call the Highway Department. They're open from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Monday through Friday. That number also on your screen. The county says all comments have to be submitted, though, by this Sunday, January 7th. Minnesota's state flag, here it is, getting a makeover. It's stirring up some passionate debate among Minnesotans. Last spring, lawmakers launched a redesign effort, and in December, a selection committee unveiled the new design. But how do Minnesotans feel about the new flag facelift? News 8's Allison Furgit traveled to La Crescent to find out.
Out with the old and in with the new.
My initial thought is it seems kind of plain.
Minnesotans have a lot to say about their new state flag.
I'd at least put the loon back on it. I think that would be appropriate.
Last spring, the Minnesota State Legislature ordered a new state seal and flag to be designed, largely because critics said the images on the previous designs were problematic. The old state seal shows a white farmer plowing his field as a Native American rides off into the distance. The state seal was a prominent part of the old flag, which is why it also got a makeover.
I do agree that the old one with the center is just way too much on there.
I like the new one better.
What do you like about the new one?
I don't know, it's just, that one's too busy.
More than 2,600 Minnesotans submitted a proposal, and after months of debate, the Emblems Redesign Commission settled on this design. The dark blue shape is to resemble Minnesota's outline. Inside of it, a white eight-pointed North Star representing the nickname the North Star State. And the light blue on the flag represents water, something the selection committee thought was perfect for the land of 10,000 lakes.
But I like it less abstract, a little more real.
But many Minnesotans are looking for more state representation.
Like, where's our state bird? I mean, there's things that could go in there that could have been added that it just seems very plain.
Loons are Minnesota's state bird, so let's do it.
The state seal also got a makeover. That new look has gotten a much warmer reception.
Oh, I like that. Oh, I like that a lot.
I like the state seal. I really do like that because it has a loon on there.
I'm proud of that. I'm not so proud of the flag.
The people want their loon. Unless rejected by the state legislature, the new emblem will become official on May 11th. That's Minnesota Statehood Day. And this isn't the only thing that's changing in Minnesota. Later in the newscast, we'll take a quick look at some of the state's new license plate options. The time now is 6:08, still to come. We'll take a look at some of the workforce and consumer trends you can expect in 2024 and tell you why they matter for your wallet.
A family lost tens of thousands of dollars in a case of cyber kidnapping. I'm Bradley Blackburn with how the scam works and how experts say you can protect yourself.
For now, we're sending you to break with something to put the good in your morning. Something fun to kick off your Thursday. An Oklahoma gamer just made history by doing something nobody has ever done before. He beat Tetris. Fans have been trying to beat the puzzle since it came out in 1984. After 40 years of fast-falling cubes, awkward tees, and those pesky L pieces, many people just didn't think it was possible. Until now, 13-year-old Willis Gibson got so far in Tetris, his score hit 999,999, and at that point, the game just shut off. Word of the win, sending waves of excitement through the community. You can see how excited he is here in that video. Now, when he described the experience, Willis said, quote, "I can't feel my fingers." Don't go anywhere. Your consumer news at News 8 Now this morning is after the break.
At Dahl Auto, we've had customers ask, why are your prices so low? The simple answer is, we price our pre-owned vehicles to sell. When you're shopping around, we want you asking, why are their prices so high? Dahl Auto.
Time is running out on Southern Minnesota's biggest and best furniture sale, the huge New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain. It's everything you've asked for, like 36-month special financing, store-wide sale prices, and free gas just for shopping. At Drury's, you'll save on area's finest selection of quality brands like Smith Brothers, FlexSteel, and Daniel's Amish, all at incredible savings. The New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain, but you'll have to hurry. It all ends Monday at 8.
Craving authentic Mexican flavors? Look no further than Señor Villa. At Señor Villa, we bring the taste of Mexico to your table every day. Join us for our unbeatable $5 lunch specials packed with flavor and value. And don't miss our nightly specials where the fiesta never ends. Señor Villa, where great food meets great value. Visit us today. Señor Villa, the taste of Mexico you've been craving.
I've been helping people get out of debt for many years, and I know this, that consolidation loans and moving debt around isn't the best way to do it. Think of your debt as a pile of garbage. If you move it from here to here, guess what? Still a pile of garbage. We might be able to make it smell sweeter with a lower rate or a lower payment, but it's still garbage. You need a garbage disposal to get rid of debt. Come see me, I'll help you install one.
Wow, Forest Berry Fudge is amazing.
Mmm, this is melting in my mouth.
Dill pickle? Whoa, that's actually good.
Mmm, holy fudge, this is the best thing ever.
Expressions, brought to you by Valley Fudge and Candy. Find us in Coon Valley, Wisconsin, or order online today.
Introducing Ultimate Precision LLC, your trusted partner for precision craftsmanship. From interior to exterior, our expert painters bring life to your vision with impeccable precision. Our masonry and building restoration team breathes new life into the old, preserving history for generations to come. We're the masters of tuck pointing, securing your structure's integrity one brick at a time. Ultimate Precision LLC, where craftsmanship meets perfection. We're here to deliver the ultimate precision.
How much time do you spend comparing prices on pre-owned vehicles? At Dahl Auto, we're comparing prices every day, all week, all year. Because we want our price to be the best price by far. Dahl Auto.
Glad you're with us on your Thursday morning. It's almost... ...6:13 right now. It's pretty cloudy across the area. That's about it at this point. In La Crosse, it's about 27, feels like 20. We've got a light wind. We'll have the winds on the lighter side out of the southwest today. Chilly in Eau Claire. It's 19 right now. It's very calm. 23 Menominee Trempealeau at 27 right now. Feels like 20. There's some spots where we have maybe a 5-mile-an-hour wind. It's more on the calmer side. La Crosse County today, highs Berry Mills, 30. West Salem 29, on Alaska 30, about 29 for the expected high in Holman. Further south, Prairie du Chien, maybe 31, Harpers Ferry 31, same for Lynxville, Stoddard potentially 29, Brownsville about 30 for the high, Caledonia 28. Working our way a little further north, Melrose 28, same for Arcadia, Winona 29, Mondovi expecting a high of 27 today. And in the Chippewa Valley, 25 Chippewa Falls, Bloomer 25, 23 for Ladysmith. On the chilly side, Cornell 24, same for Stanley's high today. Mix of sun and clouds through our day today. You're outside for any period of time this morning. Towards like the 7 o'clock hour, mid-20s, cloudy skies, but the wind's on the lighter side. Perhaps a little more sunshine later on this afternoon. We'll struggle to hit 30 today. A dry day for us, a little more sunshine. How about the next chance of snow? It's inevitable, right? We've got to show you when we have a chance of seeing some snow. That is coming up, your full forecast, less than 5 minutes away.
In your consumer news this morning, we'll take a look at the trends that may matter to your wallet in the new year. 2023 is over, but labor unions are not slowing down. Workers were so successful on the picket line last year, it was dubbed the summer of the strike. That included strikes by Hollywood writers and actors, auto workers, and healthcare professionals. Now, Vice President Kamala Harris is meeting with culinary workers in Nevada, congratulating them on new contracts with casinos. Those agreements include big raises and better job security. The trip comes as the White House ramps up campaign efforts in battleground states. Another trend that looks like it'll continue in 2024, record high electric vehicle sales. IRS tax credits meant it was cheaper than ever to buy an EV in 2023, which experts say drove up sales. Now the agency says it's updating those tax rules for the new year. Fewer EVs will be eligible for the big $7,500 credit, but there is good news. Consumers can now get tax credits applied to the purchase price of their new car instead of having to wait to file their taxes to cash in. Many people kicking off January with resolutions to eat healthy and work out more, but some people are ringing in the new year by changing up their work life. That could mean adding a part-time gig for some extra cash, starting a whole new job, or just making sure you're ready for whatever life may throw your way this year. Whatever your goals are, updating your resume is a good place to start. Career expert Amanda Augustine has some tips to make sure your credentials are on point.
And how can I highlight a certain outcome or accomplishment that allowed me to leverage those skills? Let me mention them at the top of my resume and those core competencies, but then in the work history, I want to detail out and give examples of how I've leveraged those skills to provide value to my employers.
She also says it's a good idea to read your resume out loud to catch any typos or inconsistencies. According to the Labor Department data out this week, there were 8.6 million job openings nationwide in November. That's down from previous months, but still higher than historical levels. A family was duped out of tens of thousands of dollars when their son was the victim of cyber kidnapping. The strange case shows how scams are growing way more sophisticated. Bradley Blackburn has the details and what you can do to protect your family.
On New Year's Eve, authorities found a 17-year-old student camping alone in the Utah snow after he was forced into the wilderness by virtual kidnappers. The exchange student was told his family in China was in danger unless he isolated himself away from society and law enforcement. Police say the online scammers ordered him to take pictures they used to extort money from his relatives.
The family in China believes that the kidnappers are actually with their son. And so through these three-way phone calls and then with the photographs and whatnot. So it's kind of a double blind, if you will.
The boy's family sent some $80,000 to the criminals before they realized it was all a hoax. U.S. authorities worked with Chinese officials on the case. They believe other exchange students have been targeted in similar scams.
They're on the other side of the world, so it helps the cyber criminals.
Security expert Scott Schober says these crimes are growing more sophisticated.
These scams are continually evolving. What doesn't work, then they're going to try to switch up the tactics and try something else.
To protect yourself, experts say think carefully before you post personal details online, like birthdays. Make sure you're using two-factor authentication and complex passwords for your accounts.
And if there's a threat, someone's demanding money, it's an urgent situation, take a step back and call police.
Call police. First thing to do, call police. Again, they're trained, they're professional, they do this every single day.
And be aware that these days, anyone can be a target.
Some scammers have even used AI to fake voices or images of supposed kidnapping victims. Experts say criminals often gather information from online posts and use it for social engineering. So be mindful of what you're posting online. That does it for your morning consumer news. The time now is 6:19. Time to check in with Jeff for a look at today's forecast. Hi, Jeff.
Hello, Alexandra. As you step two out the door, and you and I noticed it a little earlier than most, but it's quiet. No real shockers. Yes, it's chilly. It's also January, right? Cloud cover across our area, across the country. It's pretty active along the East Coast right now. For us, not so much. Just the rather thick cloud cover. It's been really slow to clear. We'll see a little bit of that today. 27 right now, La Crosse. Feels like 20. Just a light breeze, 5 miles an hour-ish. Eau Claire, a little chillier. 19 right now. Feels like. Because it's calm. It's calm on. All right, the big picture, this is kind of what I'm watching here as we go through the course of the next handful of days. For us, minimal cloud cover compared to the last few days. Then we cloud back up as we get into Friday. Notice perhaps some light snow flakes in there. We've got a system that's going to approach as we get a little closer and into the weekend. As it rolls around, this is a look at Saturday night. You see that we have the potential for some light snow across the area out ahead of that system. Now, as far as it adding up, this is what it looks like Saturday night into Sunday morning. Further north, perhaps an inch or two. Most of us a dusting to maybe a half inch. Now, this is down the road a few days, but I wanted to look at it just for, because I wanted to. All right, the potential storm on Tuesday. It likely will be a storm, but not necessarily for us. It's projecting we could see a couple inches of snow. The majority of it's going to track to our south and likely miss us. Still time as it evolves. It could shift a little bit and likely will to some extent. By noon today, mix of sun and clouds, about 26, upper 20s for our destination today. Perhaps 30 La Crosse, 27 Eau Claire, Ladysmith, maybe about 23 for the high temperature. That's about it today. Black River Falls and Sparta, 27, 28, respectively. All right, as far as average, talk about that an awful lot. It is about 28, couple weeks, 27. The end of the month, early February, 29. This is the first part of March, up to 40. All right, a little chillier for Eau Claire as far as the averages. Once again, potentially 30 for our high today. Tonight down to 20. For our Friday, we're going to have more cloud cover, about 34 for the high temperature tomorrow. Saturday, mostly cloudy with a high about 36. On Sunday, slight chance of seeing some light snow. The timing of that could be late Saturday night, early Sunday. Once again, looks to be light. Sunday's high under partly sunny skies, 33. We roll into next week. We're trending a little cooler and also the potential for maybe a little bit more of snow. Alexandra?
All right, we will be watching. Thank you, Jeff. The time now is 6:20. 6:22, still to come on your morning news. If one of your 2024 New Year's resolutions is to eat healthier this year, you may want to stick around. Coming up, we'll take a look at what diet has been ranked the best overall diet for the seventh year in a row.
The UWL women's basketball team has won four straight. Eagles tipping off WIAC play last night at Mitchell Hall. Plus, the Bucks were looking to bounce back against the Pacers. All that coming up in the Blitz.
Hardee's double deals start at $2.99. Choose a double cheeseburger, bacon double cheeseburger, or new barbecue bacon double cheeseburger. $2.99 never looks so good. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
We know you care, but if this is all too real for you and your loved ones, make the call, because we care too. Home Instead. To us, it's personal.
Thousands of our heroes face the difficult choice between keeping their heat and power on or facing homelessness. 21,000 Wisconsin veterans are living below the poverty line, many impacted by physical or mental health challenges. Wisconsin loses three veterans to suicide every week. Together, our mission is to provide all struggling Wisconsin veterans with a critical survival safety net that keeps them safely in their homes. You can make a real difference by providing a donation to the Wisconsin Heat and Housing for Heroes Initiative, with 95 cents of every dollar donated going directly to those right here in your community. Help by visiting www.heatforheroes.org or by calling 1-800-891-9276. That's 800-891-9276.
The one certainty in dentistry is nothing fixes itself. So small problems can turn into big problems if people wait. So they shouldn't wait.
Almost every time people say, "Man, that really wasn't that bad. I wish I had done that sooner."
We're a very implant-focused practice, so we deal with a lot of people who are losing teeth. If you've been avoiding solving it or waiting a long time, there's really no reason not to just solve it now.
If you think you have a full mouth of challenges, why don't you come down and meet us and see what we can do to help you?
There's always a solution.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose your favorite flavors for endless combinations. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Download the News 8000 app today.
Welcome to the Blitz. The UW lacrosse women's basketball team began the season 3-4, but since that point, the Eagles have reeled off four straight wins, and they're red hot as conference play tipped off last night. Let's go to Mitchell Hall. Eagles opening WIAC play against UW River Falls. Pick it up first quarter. Lauren Milne knocks down the J. Lacrosse up four. Then more from the home team. Kylie Meeker racing to the cup. Strong finish off the glass. Count it. Plus the foul. Eagles go up by seven. But the Falcons clawing back. Nice drive here. This goes off the window for two plus one. It's back to a five-point game. Other end, Eagles get hot. Katie Walkhouse, step back three. Money. Lacrosse still in front. River Falls still fighting back, though. Zoe Buchan, again, this time from downtown. She drains the three. It's a two-point game. Eagles answer, though. First half winding down. It's Meeker in the lane. She gets this one to fall. Lacrosse trailed going into the locker room, but in the second half, Eagles turning it up a notch. Milne stopping on a dime for two. Then later in the third, Madison Kilboten spots up in the corner. She knocks down the three. Back and forth game at Mitchell Hall, but the Eagles open up conference play with the win, 66-62. As for the men's squad, the Eagles were on the road last night, tipping off WIAC play against the Falcons. Lacrosse comes up short in River Falls, 71-62. Eagles led it by three at the break, but UWL outscored 38-26 in the second half. Eagles dropped their conference opener. They'll have a chance to get back on track Saturday at home against UW Stevens Point. Bucks back on the road last night looking for a win over those pesky Pacers. Tight one in the second. Bucks up one until this turnover. Aaron Naismith takes it all the way. Indiana jumps back in front. Bucks answer back, though. Dame Lillard goes around the screen, gets hit from behind. Doesn't matter. Milwaukee goes up three. Then off the inbounds pass, Chris Middleton bullies his way up for two. And the foul, it's a five-point lead. But second half, all Pacers. Miles Turner is going to throw it down. Indiana goes up by a dozen. Then more sloppy play from the Bucks. Buddy Hield gets the steal off the backboard to Isaiah Jackson for the slam. And the Oshkosh native Tyrese Haliburton, another dominant performance. Game high 31 points on the night for him. Bucks drop their second straight, 142 to 130. T-Wolves back at home last night hosting the Pelicans. Second quarter, Minnesota down 5 until Naz Reid connects from downtown. That cuts it back to 2. But on the other end, Brandon Ingram says, I can do that as well. He knocks down the 3. Then in the third, Pelicans rolling. C.J. McCollum splashes home the triple. New Orleans goes up by a dozen. And the Pels start pulling away. Look at this defense here. Big time block from Zion Williamson. And that leads to this other end. It's Ingram again. Fall away. Jay is pure. Tough night for the T-Wolves. They drop their second straight, 117 to 106. That's going to do it for the Blitz. We'll see you tonight.
Ashley's New Year's sale is going on now. Right now, shop Hot Buys for every room of your home and shop new collections with 0% interest through January 2029 in-store only. Celebrate and save today. Only at Ashley.
I'm coming.
You didn't tell me you were getting McDonald's.
Buy a sausage biscuit, sausage McMuffin, or sausage McGriddles and get one for $1.
Join today's shoppers as they explore Sweet Valley Artisans.
There's so many good things here. How do you pick just one?
You don't.
I've been looking for something to hang in my garage.
What about this or this?
Vintage clothing and accessories? Let's check it out. Have you found anything yet?
Yeah?
I'm getting hungry just looking at this.
I know what you mean.
Step in and find your treasure today.
News 8 Now and Dairyland Power Cooperative present the Community Calendar.
Enjoy an evening of folk music as the Pump House Regional Arts Center presents John Smith with Dan Sobranek, Larry Dalton, and Elise Smith-Waller, January 12th and 13th at 7:30 p.m. It's the Midwest Players Classic High School Basketball Showcase, Friday and Saturday, January 12th and 13th, happening at the La Crosse Center.
For more information on these events, or if you'd like to submit an event, visit news8000.com.
Our hearing connects us with people. And when that bridge is broken, our job is to help people with that hearing loss and reconnect them back with their lives again. We really feel that better hearing is a better life.
Happy holidays from everyone at Better Hearing Center.
When migraine strikes, are the trade-offs of treating worth it? Ubrelvy is another option. It quickly eliminates migraine pain.
Do not take with strong CYP3A4 inhibitors. Allergic reactions to Ubrelvy can happen. Most common side effects were nausea and sleepiness.
Ask about Ubrelvy.
Make the resolution to get better sleep this new year with a new mattress from Ashley. With 0% interest through January 2029 on in-store mattress purchases, get 50% off select Sealy mattresses or 25% off select Ashley Sleep mattresses only at Ashley.
The First Warn Weather app. Download it today. Thank you for watching News 8 Now. Expect more.
Welcome back. In your medical news this morning, how'd you sleep last night? A new study reveals getting a bad night's sleep may not only make you tired the next day, it could affect you 10 years from now. In the study, researchers looked at the sleep quality of people in their 30s and 40s and then gave 500 of them cognitive tests 10 years later. They found those with more interruptions in their sleep were more than twice as likely to develop memory and thinking problems a decade later. If eating healthier is one of your New Year's resolutions, you may want to look into a Mediterranean diet. U.S. News & World Report is ranking it as the best overall diet for the seventh year in a row. The diet consists primarily of fruits, veggies, whole grains, beans, seeds, and fish, which all contain omega-3 fatty acids. According to the National Institutes of Health, omega-3 fatty acids can lower the risk of developing cardiovascular disease and age-related macular degeneration. The diet also took first as the best diet for diabetes, best for bone and joints, and best diet for healthy eating. Speaking of hitting goals, 2024 is here, and so are people's resolutions to live healthier. It's one of the most popular New Year's resolutions as people aspire to refreshed mental, physical, and spiritual well-being. But as the calendar changes, so do those everyday workout excuses. To keep your fitness goals on track, News 8 Now's Michael Germain met with a Gunderson wellness consultant who has some advice on making wellness wins stick in the new year.
It's always good to think of goals that are specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and you have a time factor. Figure out when you're gonna do your goals.
If you're thinking about being more active for 2024, Bolin adds you should aim for a 30-minute workout at least 5 times a week.
So if you think about exercising for 30 minutes a day, if you haven't exercised in a while, maybe break those 30 minutes into 3 10-minute segments.
While trying to achieve your New Year's resolution, it is important to have a positive mindset.
It's not going to be easy. You might have hiccups along the way. Things might not go as you planned, but brush that off, move on, and figure out maybe what caused you to not accomplish your goal on any given day.
Even though many folks set resolutions for the new year, Bolin adds it's best to think long term.
It's also important to keep setting goals, whether they're big or small, throughout the entire year, just to stay motivated, make your health and your happiness a priority all year long.
While hitting the gym and living a healthier lifestyle may be the most popular resolution, there are many other ways to improve your health.
Maybe it's learning a new hobby. Maybe it's taking a woodworking class. Maybe it's crafting. Whatever you want to do to better your physical and mental health, those are good goals to set.
A longtime YMCA member, Tim Ebner, says this time of year, he sees a rise in people flooding the floors.
Well, you always see an increase at this time of the year. It's just where people start to really think about what they want this upcoming year to be, and this is a good place to start here at the Y.
Gunderson officials add setting goals with a specific plan is key to achieving them. The Children's Museum of La Crosse is welcoming some special guests. The organization known as Drawn Together is a group of artists that travel around La Crosse and paint. The group likes to find inspiration from unique places. This week they decided to spend time in the Children's Museum drawing in their sketchbooks. One artist says the best thing about the group is being able to connect with other artists.
Being in contact with the people, people who are going through the same kinds of challenges that all artists do, encouraging each other, giving each other feedback.
Gunn says right now there are about 18 members in the Drawn Together group. It's made of working artists, people looking to start their art careers, and people who just like to make art as a hobby. Earlier in the newscast, we took a look at what Minnesotans thought about changes to the state flag. But the state flag is not the only thing getting a change. Minnesotans can now show off their favorite sports teams with new license plates. Uba Ali gives us a closer look at some of the state's new specialty plate designs.
From the field to the dugout, Minnesota sports fans can now showcase their pride beyond the stands and on the road. With 9 special license plates, including pro sports teams, 2 nonprofits, and a blackout look.
We're excited to see those plates on the road starting today.
It gives our fans a chance to be able to show their pride.
The new plates will cost about $15 and require a minimum annual contribution of $30.
Proceeds will go towards charitable organizations like the Minnesota Vikings Foundation and its mission to advance youth health and education, or the Minnesota Community Twins Fund supporting healthy children on and off the field.
So it's a great way for fans to show off their excitement and passion for the Minnesota Vikings, while helping support a wonderful cause.
Brett Tabor with the Minnesota Vikings Foundation says this is a tangible way to make a difference.
That $30 that a fan were able to contribute, that means real tangible meals for kids in our communities.
For Twins Territory, an opportunity to reach more children.
Community fund funds programs and opportunities for youth to be able to connect with our game.
Drivers can also get plates to benefit the Lions Club, and the boldest plate is the blackout plate featuring white lettering. It's been so popular in other states, drivers ask for it to be added. Proceeds will help programs at DVS.
If you'd like to get one of those new specialty plates, you can visit your local deputy registrar's office or visit the Minnesota Public Safety Department's website. Time now, 6:37. Here's News 8 Now. Meteorologist Jeff Andrews, tell us what to expect while taking those new license plates out for a spin on our morning commute.
A lot of cloud cover, then we'll have a little bit of sun mixed in as well. The wind's on the lighter side, temperatures close to normal. Generally, that's why get the green light across the board. I don't really see anything, any real issues with the weather interacting with our driving today. A lot of cloud cover, flurries, more than likely, really nothing making it to the ground, just a lot of cloud cover. Eau Claire, the chilly spot right now, 19, 18 in Ladysmith. La Crosse is at 27, Winona 27, Black River Falls and Sparta at 24, a little further south, Prairie du Chien at 29. Mix of sun and clouds today, perhaps hitting 30 with light winds. Tonight, dropping down to 20. Chilly night ahead for us. A little more cloud cover. The winds will be on the light side. Eau Claire, perhaps 27 for the high today with a mix of sun and clouds and a light breeze. Tonight, down to 18. Quiet day again. Snow isn't too far off. Got to take a look at that, let you know when to expect that, prepare for it. I'll have that in your full forecast. I'll have that coming up in just about 5 minutes or so. We'll actually have that next. We're going to follow that up with your morning buzz report. And we'll be right back.
Hardee's Double Deal start at $2.99. Choose a double cheeseburger, bacon double cheeseburger, or new barbecue bacon double cheeseburger. $2.99 never looked so good. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Time is running out on Southern Minnesota's biggest and best furniture sale, the huge New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain. It's everything you've asked for, like 36-month special financing, store-wide sale prices, and free gas just for shopping. At Drury's, you'll save on area's finest selection of quality brands like Smith Brothers, FlexSteel, and Daniel's Amish, all at incredible savings. The New Year sale at Drury's in Fountain, but you'll have to hurry. It all ends Monday at 8.
Hello, I'm Christy Halenka, Reading Program Chair at Viterbo University. Viterbo is proud to serve our area communities by providing programs that produce quality educators and leadership in our schools. Viterbo University is once again partnering with News 8 to recognize outstanding classroom teachers in the area. We look forward to working with generations of teachers and change agents for years to come. Do you know a top-notch teacher? Then go online to news8000.com or write to this address.
Hischke Motors has been family-owned and operated since 1920 and have you to thank for our continued success. Stop into our Jeep 4x4 headquarters in downtown La Crosse or West Salem to find the Jeep you're looking for. Get in a Renegade, Grand Cherokee, Compass, Wrangler, or Gladiator today. We've got great deals on new Jeeps right now. When you find the perfect Jeep, you'll feel it.
Start your search at Hischke.com.
And drive away in your new Jeep.
George and Heidi use Verizon. Dan and Tina have Spectrum Mobile. With Verizon, George and Heidi pay way more for their two unlimited lines. With Spectrum, Dan and Tina get one unlimited mobile line for $29.99 and their second line free. And with Spectrum, there are no added taxes or hidden fees. Dan and Tina save big, over $1,500 in savings. So George and Heidi, what do you think?
We're switching to Spectrum.
Get one unlimited line for $29.99 and get your next line free. Call, click, or visit a Spectrum store today.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose your favorite flavors for endless combinations. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Pretty cloudy as we get things rolling. It's a quiet start to our day today. See all the cloud cover across the area. Across the country, some activity along the west coast. Real active weather, at least most active, looks to be on the east coast right now. Zooming in, you see we just have mainly cloudy skies across our area. That's really about it. It's 27 La Crosse, feels like 20. A light breeze right now. Eau Claire, it's pretty calm. A little chillier, calm. That was one of the elements that allow the temperatures to drop a little bit. That's why it's 19. That's part of the reason why. Sky Tracker across the area expects us to have a little bit of sunshine during the day today, more so than the last couple of days. We've got a couple of things brewing as we advance a little further. We get into Friday, perhaps a few snowflakes. This is Friday afternoon, not likely for us, but maybe parts of Minnesota. As we roll into Saturday night, we've got this system that could bring some light snow across the area. That go around. As far as some snow, you look further north, perhaps inch or two or so. Most of us, likely less than an inch, maybe just a dusting to a half inch of snow. Saturday at some point into Sunday, still fine-tuning the timing on that a little bit. I looked a little further down the road. You go down the road, or at least a few days down the road, things can wobble quite a bit, but it looks like the storm will likely track quite a ways to our south. We could get a couple inches of snow out of it, a few spots, maybe a little bit more, but more than likely, at least the bulk of it looks to be tracking to our south. Today, a mix of sun and clouds. Most of our day likely spent in the 20s. Few spots may hit 30 today. Eau Claire 27, Viroqua 27, Boscobel 33, 31, likely high in Prairie du Chien. Over the longer stretch, we've been seeing a lot of this. High confidence in well above normal temperatures. We're easing our way back a bit. I'm starting to see a little more of this. This would be considered normal. We're still expected to be slightly above over the 10-day stretch. We go a little further than that, we start to see temperatures a little close to or maybe even a little bit below normal. For today, a mix of sun and clouds, perhaps 30 for a high today, dropping down to 20 tonight. For tomorrow, your Friday, cloudy skies, a high about 34. Friday night into Saturday, 27. Saturday, partly sunny, up to 36. On Sunday, a high of 33. At some point, slight chance of seeing a little bit of snow. As we get into early next week, better chance of seeing something more measurable. Watching that closely, but like I touched on a few minutes ago or seconds ago, really, the bulk of the precipitation looks to be well to our south.
In our morning buzz report, today we're bringing you a spotlight on movies that deal with history because sometimes the best story is a true story. Some of the most acclaimed movies of 2023 tackled history, including Martin Scorsese's Killers of the Flower Moon, which just grabbed 4 wins at the Alliance of Women Film Journalists Awards. The epic Western drama took home the trophies for Best Actress and Best Breakthrough Performance for star Lily Gladstone. It also won Best Cinematography and Best Editing.
Thank you. You almost made me cry.
Speaking of talented women, Paramount is releasing the trailer for its upcoming documentary about June Carter Cash. The doc will tell the story of the country icon with rare and never-before-seen footage. Although married to fellow Nashville star Johnny Cash, June was a music legend and pioneer of her own. Fans can learn all about the life of the 5-time Grammy winner when June premieres on January 16th.
Sabemos dónde estamos. Pasa cuando el mundo te abandona.
That was a quick peek at historical drama Society of the Snow. It's a true story about a rugby team whose plane crashes in the Andes Mountains in 1972. The survival thriller explores how 16 members of the team overcame incredible odds to survive. Society of the Snow landed in theaters late last month and is already getting major Oscar buzz from critics. It currently holds a 92% rating on Rotten Tomatoes.
Sadly, now federal agents have learned what the locals long suspected, that the group calling itself God's Marines would not give up without a fight.
Another harrowing true story that just hit streaming, the FBI True episode Waco, is a two-part look at the 1993 standoff between federal law enforcement and members of the Branch Davidian. You may remember that group as the cult that waged a bloody gun battle with the FBI before holing up for a 51-day siege at their Texas compound. Four federal agents died in the firefight, while 82 Branch Davidians died when the siege ended in a fire. The events in Waco remain controversial today. You can watch FBI True on Paramount Plus now. Lots of movies to educate yourself, get your thrills in.
Get scared.
Yeah.
And yesterday, afraid to come out of the pool.
Right.
Today,
afraid to go on a plane.
Plane in the snow, yeah.
Yes, you'll get your thrills in for sure. And before we head to break, it's time to look at today's Look Who's 8.
All right, Camden turns 8 today. He likes to practice karate, play video games, and he loves math.
All right, smart guy. Happy birthday to him. We've got Ruth turning 88 years old. She's a huge fan of all of the major Wisconsin sports teams, loves playing bingo and watching game shows.
You know somebody special that is turning 8, 18, 80, 88, 8 weeks, what have you? We love to feature them.
Yes, just upload their photo to our website, news8000.com, and look for the Submit Pictures button on the homepage. Time now is 6:48. Stay with us. We have everything you need to know in 5 minutes or less. Your morning news now is just after the break.
Coming up on CBS Mornings, the latest on the newly released Jeffrey Epstein documents. Legal analyst Ricky Kleeman will join us to break down what they mean for those who have been named. Plus, in our series, The Dish, Nate introduces us to a seasoned chef with a legacy of creating some of the nation's most delectable fried chicken. His talents have earned him a coveted James Beard nomination. Also, best-selling author and psychologist Adam Grant is known for motivational advice. Well, he's here to tell us how we can all reach our potential in the new year. And we're just days away from this year's Golden Globe. Only on CBS Mornings will reveal some of the presenters, and comedian Joe Coy joins us to talk about his first time hosting the award show. We'll see you at 7.
Has your pet been diagnosed with a cruciate ligament injury or torn ACL? Forget the inconvenience of travel and expense to a university. Dr. Mark Hine at Wisconsin Veterinary Orthopedics in Holman specializes in knee reconstruction using the TPLO. This is a gold standard that's been used by veterinarians for over 40 years and provides the strongest fixation in ACL repair. Fetch made possible, one knee at a time. Contact Dr. Mark Hine at Wisconsin Veterinary Orthopedics today.
This isn't Charmin. No wonder I don't feel as clean.
Here's Charmin Ultra Strong.
Ah, my bottom's been saved.
With its diamond weave texture, Charmin Ultra Strong cleans better with fewer sheets and less effort. Enjoy the go with Charmin.
It ain't my dad's razor, Dad.
Hey, watch it.
It's from Gillette Labs. This green bar releases trapped hairs from my face.
Game changer.
Well, the Flex This contours to it, so the 5 blades can get virtually every hair in one stroke for the ultimate Gillette shaving experience.
The best a man can get
is Gillette Labs.
Cold weather and winter winds remind us that old windows and doors are not our friends. New windows and doors, expertly installed by certified installers, bring comfort, convenience, energy savings, and a great new look. Begin now in choosing just the right windows for your home. Order now and avoid the inevitable price increase in the new year. No worries about missing a promotion. The Board Store offers you the best possible price every day and any day. Contact us online or visit our showroom for a prompt free estimate on windows and doors or other home improvements.
If you want the best dental care ever, come to Grand River Dental. They will take care of you. They put you in control of your own treatment. It was like over and done with in a short amount of time. You'll walk out of here feeling great and probably want more work done because they do such an awesome job. I mean, look at how pretty these look. It'll change your life.
We're an implant-focused practice. If you think you have a full mouth of challenges, come see me. Come down for a free consultation.
Jennifer Hudson Show. I turn the spotlight on you. Inspiring stories.
You are changing lives.
I can do it.
That's right.
The biggest stars.
You have your own show.
I love Jennifer.
There you go.
I just pull up.
You'll be flirting with everybody.
You damn right.
And did I mention the surprises?
I would have worn my good wig.
Weekdays at 4 on News 8. The 8,000 Plus app. Stream on your time.
Two people back in Vernon County Court for drug trafficking and possession charges. 37-year-old Mark McKibben and 36-year-old Melinda Stahlsberg were arrested in November after officers executed a search warrant and found 47 grams of meth, several bags of fentanyl, and cash, according to the county sheriff. McKibben is charged with felony counts of maintaining a drug trafficking place and possession with intent to deliver methamphetamine and fentanyl. Stahlsberg charged with a felony count of possession with intent to deliver meth. Both also facing a misdemeanor count of possession of drug paraphernalia. They are out on bond. A new Wisconsin bill would require UW officials to give all first-year students information on how they can vote as an absentee in their home states. State Representative Clint Moses is sponsoring the bill. The Menominee Republican says it would allow those out-of-state students to vote in their home districts where they know more about local issues. He says he's concerned about students deciding local races like school board or referendum. Democrats argue the bill is just an attempt to turn away likely Democratic voters in a purple state. Wisconsin led the nation in youth turnout in the 2022 midterms. The La Crosse County Highway Department is asking for public comment on the county's proposed 2024 ATV routes. Residents can send in their questions or opinions about the expected routes to the county highway commissioner. You see his email address there on your screen, or you can give the highway department a call between 7 and 3 Monday through Friday. That number also on your screen. The county says all comments do need to be submitted by this Sunday, January 7th. A new year means many people are embracing New Year's resolutions for a healthier lifestyle. A wellness consultant at Gunderson has some tips to help you turn your January goals into an all-year reality. If you're thinking about being more active in 2024, they suggest aiming for a 30-minute workout at least 5 times a week. And remember to think long-term. Multiple small goals throughout the year can go a long way.
It's great to set goals in January, but it's also important to keep setting goals, whether they're big or small, throughout the entire year, just to stay motivated, make your health and your happiness a priority all year long.
Boland also says have a plan in place when you're setting your goals. This will make it easier to reach.
Well, I'd say the appropriate jacket for 20s. 27 La Crosse. There's another weather station near La Crosse that's showing 20. Regardless, it's winter. 19 Eau Claire right now. In Viroqua, 25. Prairie du Chien and Bosque Belle, about 29. It's generally 20s. We go through your day today. Not going to move a whole lot, mainly in the 20s. Some spots, likely about 30 today. The winds will be on the lighter side, fortunately. And likely a little bit of sunshine today, but quickly the overcast conditions continue. Maybe some light snow over the weekend.
Hold off on sipping your coffee for a moment. We're about to take a walk on the wild side to finish up our show this morning. A group of senior women in Massachusetts getting ready, getting saucy for a good cause and showing that sometimes age is just a number. The ladies range from their late 60s to early 90s, and they came up with a creative and spicy way to raise money for their senior living community. The group held a boudoir photo shoot and put together a flirty calendar in the name of charity. They've already sold more than 700 copies to raise $14,000, something you don't see every day. Good for them.
When you said saucy, I thought maybe, you know, Alfredo marinara or something like that.
Barbecue sauce. No.
Unexpected as far as me.
A different kind of sauce for sure. But yeah, age is just a number, right?
Correct. I mean, who am I to judge, really?
Exactly. It's for a good cause. Yeah. So there you go. Well, thanks so much for joining us this morning. We'll see you back here at noon. Have a great day, everyone.